Hello, this is 13 Heathen speaking, and since you've clicked on this video, you're either one of my subscribers or you've been looking up the Kalam Cosmological Argument. And if that's the case, I'm going to assume that you're already familiar with it. I've decided to take this argument and follow it until it gets to the point that it completely breaks down as a reasonable logical argument. Premise 1. Everything that begins to exist has a cause. Well, that was certainly quick. Wait a minute. William Lane Craig uses this as his big argument, and Christians and Muslims alike think this is a good argument. Or at least a good starter one. People claiming to be philosophers try using this shit. That's just sad. Within the framework of philosophy, it's impossible to prove anything actually exists. The only available validation of the thing's existence is when other people, whose existence must also be questioned, agree that a thing exists. At least for the sake of discussing said object, which may or may not truly exist. Even if we could grant a thing's existence, we cannot verify that any other potential consciousness would perceive said object in the same way, thus making any assumption of rudimentary existence a completely subjective assertion. And, of course, asserting a thing is true and or real does not make it so. Wait, don't stop the video. I'll drop the philosophy and explain the logical problem. The first claim hinges on the acceptance of the premise that any effect must have a cause. This is where it first all begins to unravel. If you're to look at the full scope of cause and effect within the understanding of humans, no single cause has ever been observed. It can easily be argued that there is no evidence of anything ever having a cause. Everything is merely an effect. One thing which may seem to be a causal factor is merely the reaction of said thing to other reactions to which we humans may attempt to claim as being causal factors. However, every action which we've attempted to claim to be a cause has in reality merely been the effect of other reactions. The reason I use the term actions plural is that based on even a rudimentary understanding of the broad chains of events leading to any seemingly single occurrence, it's interlinked with other reactions to other factors which were in turn triggered by other even broader chains of events. Therefore, it should be obvious that the concept of a cause is completely a human construct, just completely a construct of human reasoning. So until it can be demonstrated that anything can be shown to be an actual cause, independent of these vast chains of effects which encompass all of human experience and understanding, the entire Kalam cosmological argument is rendered null and void from the point of its first premise. Well, so much for that. This is 13 Heathens signing off.